Our next example problem deals with the pressure or the air pressure in the tires of your car. So the tires on your car have a pressure of 30 pounds per square inch at 18 degrees Celsius. If the temperature drops to 0 degrees Celsius, what is the pressure in your tires? So here we can use the combined gas law, which says P1 V1 over T1 is equal to P2 V2 over T2. Okay. In this particular case, from start to finish, when you look at your car's the volume in your tire, it's going to remain constant. Okay, so we can simplify this expression to P1 over T1 equals P2 over T2. Initially, we're going to start with a pressure of 30 pounds per square inch. Okay, our temperature is 18 degrees Celsius, but remember, we must convert that to Kelvin. That's going to equal P2, which is what we're trying to solve for, and 0 degrees Celsius, which is 273 Kelvin. If we go through, we can do our cross multiplication here, and we can find that P2 times 18 degrees Celsius plus 273 Kelvin is going to equal 30 pounds per square inch times 273 Kelvin. So if we divide our 18 plus 273 by both sides, we find that P2 is going to be equal to 28 pounds per square inch. Okay, so to kind of recap here, we're going to use the combined gas law, which allows us to look at initial and final conditions. We are changing the temperature here. So we're going from 18 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius, and we need to solve for what our pressure is. When we have a decrease in temperature, we also expect the pressure to decrease, which happens here. We go from 30 down to 28, so this answer makes sense. And practically it makes sense too, because when the temperature gets really cold outside, the air pressure in your tires is going to decrease.